Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to your first ever HTML tutorial from microtechtutorials.com. In this tutorial, I'm going to be teaching you guys some HTML and basically the layout of HTML and some other basics you might need to know. So the first thing is, this is what I will be using for making HTML pages. The reason I'm using this program called Context, I'll have the link in the description. And the reason I'm using this is at the bottom you will see it says line 1, column 1. That's the position of the code. When you write lots of code, especially with other languages, you need to know what line you're on, because in PHP it tells you the error. Now, I know this is an HTML series, but I'm starting with an HTML series because in order to do a lot of coding, you should get a... This really isn't a programming language, but it's something you should know. And if you're going to go into programming, I suggest you learn HTML, not because it teaches you how to code apps, but it kind of gives you a sense of what you're doing and how hard or easy it is to code, depending on what you're wanting to code. The next thing I wanted to tell you guys was, at the top you will see it says index.html. Sometimes it's index.html. Now, why is it called index.html? Index.html or index.htm or index.php are basically the main file of a website. So if you were to go to Google, or my website, doesn't matter, and you go to google.com/index.php, you will see the same website. This is because every code page that is in a directory like google.com/apps has an index.something page inside that folder. So that's why. Also, there is index.htm and html. Doesn't matter. Some actual web hosts used to only allow three letters. That's why some sites are .htm. It doesn't matter if it's .html. Only thing you don't want to do is link to a .html page when it's just .htm. But what you call your file extension on your own website does not matter. They are both the same thing, and they do the same thing. So let's get started. But there are also another few things I think you should know. If you want to publish your site on the web, you will need to get a web host and figure out how to make a website yourself. This is basically just learning how to code a web page yourself. So if you know how to buy a domain name, set up hosting and name servers and all that, then this tutorial is going to teach you how to just code, not do that. If you want to know how to do that, I suggest you find a different tutorial for that. Now, let's get into the basic layout. We're running out of time. This is a basic layout of a web page. You see this right here? HTML, head, title, your title, and then end title, and head, body, and head, and HTML. You see a pattern here? These things are called tags. These are basically the things that are starting a command, what type of command it basically is. So it basically tells the computer what to do. So HTML is telling it it's an HTML page. Head is telling it it's the heading information, such as the title. So let me just open up a web browser here, save this, and refresh the page. You'll see you have test web page, and this is what you call it because you have it in head. Now, don't worry, you don't have to remember what I did there. I'm just giving you an example. Header basically controls all the background information, like your title, your meta tags, and things that, if you don't know what that is, that's fine. I'm covering it in a future tutorial, so there's no reason to freak out. So let's move on. So as you can see, I had to end the title. So this is tag, basically, is an end tag. So an end tag is the same as the beginning tag, but you have a slash in it. So the beginning, this is the title tag, and then end title tag. This is the head tag. This is the end head tag. So basically, your ending attack is what you're doing. So you have that with body, HTML, and you get the point. If I were to make an image, the IMG tag is the tag you would use. Now you would do IMG SRC equals the link and slash, and then do the end tag, same thing. So this has just been a basic tutorial on the layout of HTML. You're gonna need to know that, make sure you know what you're doing. If it's index.html page or ends in an HTML extension, you really don't have to tell it it's an HTML page, but it's always highly recommended. If you were to type gibberish on a page, it would come out fine. But this has been a basic tutorial from microtechtutorials.com. Thank you guys for watching and subscribe for more.